Hello, my name is Oliver, and today I'll be talking about our Kubernetes GitHub Actions. Before we can talk about GitHub Actions, we have to first go over GitHub Workflows. GitHub Workflows automate tests, builds, and deployment, and other things. They execute on hosted virtual environments. Actions are like a step of a GitHub Workflow. Our AKS Actions allow developers to easily interact with their Kubernetes cluster all from a GitHub Workflow. They can be used alone, or together. They make them very reusable and modularized. Our starter workflows provide templates for getting started with deploying to AKS and any Kubernetes cluster. Workflows are run in response to events, such as pushing to a branch, adding a tag, making a pull request. They can be run on a cron job. They can be run by the user itself with a workflow dispatch. There's many options. We're going to go through a demo. We're starting with a new Kubernetes cluster, and we have a GitHub repository with a simple voting app in it. This voting app and GitHub repository has Kubernetes manifest files. And what we're going to do is we're going to deploy to our AKS cluster using GitHub Actions. Then we're going to change our application, and we're going to deploy those changes. So again, starting with an empty Kubernetes cluster, you can see that here. We have our GitHub repository. And if you go to the Actions tab, that's where you start all workflows with the workflow dispatch event. We can run it off. And when we refresh, we can see it. Go back to our repository. Let's look at how all this is set up. So there's a .github/workflows folder. They're all configured with YAML. So here we can see like we have the name, what it's triggering on, some environment variables, and the jobs. So under the jobs section, we can see it's running on Ubuntu. We got the steps, so we check out this repository, we log in with Azure, we build and push to Azure container registry, we get the KA's context, essentially getting the kubeconfig, we get the ACR credentials, and we're gonna create a K8 secret. So we're gonna use those ACR credentials to pull images from ACR, and then we can just deploy. Let's go back up. So how did we get all those steps? To make it easy, we have starter workflows. So if you go to the Actions tab and then hit New, you can see all our starter workflows. In this case, we picked the deploy to AKS one, and you can configure it. This makes it really easy to get started. At the top, you can see we have a comment with a lot of instructions for getting ramped up. But let's just go back to our action and check in on how it's doing. We can see the build. And it's currently in the process of deploying. We see some output, and we can see it's finished. So our application has been deployed. If you click into each individual step, you get a lot of output. You can really see what's happening. You have a lot of visibility. But let's go back to our Kubernetes cluster. If we check the pods, we'll see that they're brand new, which lines up with us just making the application. And let's check in on it. So here you can see the simple voting app. So say that we get bored of choosing between Python and Java. Let's change something to, say, a pet voting app. We're going to change our options in this repository. So this is the repository on GitHub. And we're going to commit it. And we're going to push. So if we go back to our GitHub repository, we can see our changes were pushed. And let's just kick off another deploy. So this time we're going to speed it up a little bit. You can see all the steps running. You can see the output. And it's deployed. So let's check in on it. We're going to go back to our application, refresh, and boom, we can see we now have the options of dogs and cats. All right, so as we can see, we can interact with the Kubernetes cluster completely from GitHub. It's really nice to be able to just work in one space, keep everything confined to one environment, really. What we didn't really see demonstrated is actions are super customizable. So all the action we used in this demo all have different options that we can swap in, swap out. GitHub workflows allow you to insert any steps in between, so you can really make this your own and fit your own workflow. The deploy step in particular has a lot of different strategies that we didn't demo today. What we demoed is basically the most straightforward and simplest case, but we support deployment strategies like Canary, including service mesh interface, or Kubernetes only, and also blue-green deployment strategies where you can promote or reject a deployment. We also have a bake Elm, so Azure/K8's bake. And basically, this lets you use either Helm, Customize, or Compose to generate your manifest files dynamically. So there's those two and a ton of other options. So you can learn more about our GitHub Actions at this link. There's a list of all our AKS and Kubernetes Actions. We also have a link to our starter workflows here so you can get started. So be sure to check out those resources. If you look at each individual action repository, it gives you a list of all the options available for it and exactly how to use it.